Philippine transport officials confident that Metro Manila will not be paralyzed by a fresh round of protests against the jeepney modernization program. According to the Office of Transportation Cooperatives, around 97% of jeepneys in Metro Manila have already filed for consolidation. This means only less than 3% of jeepneys in Metro Manila are unconsolidated. Transport authorities again reminding unconsolidated jeepneys they will no longer be allowed to ply their routes by February 1st.
For two consecutive years, meaning 2022 and 2023, there were around 21,042 units that have failed to confirm. So, out of the 42,642 units that were given franchise, 43% hindi na ho nag-register for the past 2 years. Marami na ho talagang operators na gusto na nila mag-retire. Perhaps after the pandemic, nag-isip-isip, napag-aral na yung mga anak, it's about time then for them to retire. Another would be their units are no longer roadworthy. Kaya for the past 2 years, hindi na sila bumabiyahe dahil hindi na nila mairerehistro din talaga yung kanilang mga units.
Meanwhile, transport groups in favor of the jeepney modernization program file a motion for intervention at the Supreme Court. Attached to the petition are groups' comments to the main petition filed by Transport Group Piston. Pasang Masa President Obet Martin denies Pison's arguments regarding a looming transport crisis and the overpriced cost of modern jeepneys. Piston filed a petition seeking a restraining order against a modernization program back in December.
Money sent home by Filipinos abroad climbed to $3 billion in November. This was higher by nearly 3% from the $2.9 billion year-on-year. It also pushed personal remittances from January to November to $33.6 billion. The central bank says the growth in remittances was driven mostly by land-based workers with long-term contracts. Cash remittances coursed through banks, meanwhile, climbed to $2.7 billion in the said period. Major country sources of the remittances were the U.S., Singapore, and Saudi Arabia.
The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department is facilitating the release of 17 Filipino seafarers being held hostage by Houthi rebels in Yemen. DFA Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega says they're aiming for the release to happen by the end of the month or at the soonest possible time. The DFA also assures the public it is in close coordination with Iran regarding 18 Filipino seafarers currently under the custody of Iranian authorities. This is after the Iranian Navy seized an oil tanker in the Gulf of Oman last week. The Iranian Embassy in Manila is extending aid to address the Philippine government's requests to visit the seafarers and secure their eventual release. In the United States, a massive winter storm is sweeping the Midwest and the East Coast. The life-threatening temperatures are causing major disruptions in the affected areas, including in the high-stakes Iowa caucus for the Republican presidential nomination. Our North America Bureau Chief TJ Monotok reports.
A brutal winter storm and Arctic blasts are gripping the Midwest and Eastern United States. The National Weather Service has issued a severe warning, with over 95 million people, or about 75% of the U.S., are under wind chill advisories, and some states expecting temperatures to plummet to a bone-chilling negative 70 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 50 degrees Celsius. The freezing conditions are wreaking havoc on various fronts, affecting political campaigns, sports events, and travel across the country. Power outages have left hundreds of thousands in the Northeast and Pacific Northwest in the dark. The Arctic blast is significantly impacting the political landscape, particularly in Iowa, where Republican presidential candidates are forced to cancel events ahead of the party's first nominating contest on Monday. A powerful blizzard has disrupted political campaigning, forcing Republican candidates to cancel events. The extreme weather has covered Des Moines, the center of the Iowa caucus's frenzy in snow, rendering political yard signs practically useless. With temperatures expected to remain frigid well into next week, there are concerns about voter turnout in Iowa's upcoming political events. An Arctic blast from Canada caused temperatures to plummet across a vast part of the country, affecting the Northwest into the Rust Belt. The winter storm also wreaked havoc across the Midwest, causing power outages for tens of thousands of households. Historic flooding hit Maine's entire coast, with Governor Janet Mills urging everyone to stay home. Extreme weather also impacted the Pacific Northwest and parts of the Northeast, with Portland, Oregon experiencing snow, ice, and strong winds. Tragically, at least two weather-related fatalities were reported. Thousands of flights were canceled over the Martin Luther King Jr. holiday weekend, and New York Governor Kathy Hochul issued a travel ban for the Erie County. The National Football League postponed the Pittsburgh Steelers versus Buffalo Bills game due to an expected blizzard. Other Filipinos in Chicago had been preparing for freezing temperatures and snow since Friday. Some even lost power for hours.
3 hours, but 2 hours what I said, I tried to get outside. I said, now it's windy. So I go back inside. I'm freezing. I mean, because there's no electricity. The temperature was from, because we put it like 74, and then it's go down to 60 degrees in the house.
I definitely made sure to fill up my gas tank in case I had to go out and stocked up on water. Nervous? No. I try to make plans around the weather, so planning to stay inside.
The extreme weather is expected to continue with dangerous conditions in the middle and southeastern United States, bringing a mix of snow, sleet, and freezing rain. Frigid air will reach the deep south, with Atlanta expecting rare 14-degree Fahrenheit weather by Wednesday. This extreme weather serves as a stark reminder of previous weather-related crises, including the February 2021 freeze in Texas and the December 2022 winter storm that nearly caused the collapse of power and natural gas systems. The Texas power grid operator ERCOT has issued an appeal for energy conservation due to low reserves caused by freezing temperatures, record-breaking demand, and unseasonably low wind. Meteorologists are forecasting some of the coldest temperatures in states like Montana, South Dakota, and North Dakota, with wind chills as low as negative 70 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 57 degrees Celsius. TJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News.